We're live here at the new headquarters. Guys, welcome. Team Carling here with you today for your MetCon class. We have me, Derek. We have Kimmy. We have Matt. And we have Saul, who's behind the camera right now, just making sure that everything is good for you guys. We've been having some issues with our Facebook Live, so hopefully everything is gonna work out today. We got a great workout planned for you guys today, a lot of high intensity stuff. We got some AMRAPs, a couple of AMRAPs lined up for you, so you don't have to follow our pace. You're just gonna go at your own pace, whether that's fast, whether that's slow, but we're all gonna move for 5 minutes at a time, times three in our main set. And before that, if you looked in the description, we have a little warm up with some dynamic movements, some isometric holds, and then some rest, okay? Matt has a little bit that he'd like to mention today.
Hey guys, how are you? In this workout today, on October 22nd, 6 years ago, Corporal Nathan Cirillo was killed on the hill guarding at the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. And this was 6 years ago. So Derek, every Friday, does a workout of a hero on giving tribute to a fallen soldier. And I just thought it was necessary today on October 22nd to mention Corporal Nathan Cirillo's name. We will be working out in his honor, as I know you guys will be at home giving it everything. And once again, this workout is for Corporal Nathan Cirillo, October 22nd, 2014.
So there is, guys, there's an actual hero workout named in his name that I am saving for tomorrow's hero workout. So if you guys are able to join us again tomorrow at noon, we might even have more friends from Carling dropping in for tomorrow's workout. We're all gonna do it together. It's gonna be a workout that's named for Nathan Cirillo. It's gonna be a really good workout, so stay tuned for that one. But first, we start with what we got going on today, okay? So our beginning, our little warm-up, we're actually gonna get right into the first part, which is three rounds, 20 seconds of dynamic movement, 20 seconds of isometric movement, and then 20 seconds of rest. So what we're gonna do is part one's gonna be some squats. We're gonna go for jump squats, so 20 seconds opening the hips, jumping, getting the feet to leave the ground. Once 20 seconds is up, we'll let you know. You're gonna hold the bottom of your squat for 20 seconds. Okay, driving the knees out, trying to keep the chest up. Arms out in front are gonna help you, and then you're gonna rest for 20 seconds. Once we're done that minute, then we're gonna go into push-ups. So we're gonna go for 20 seconds, max effort push-ups, into a 20 second high plank hold. And then from there, we're gonna go for 20 seconds of rest. And the last one's gonna be core, so we're gonna go for 20 seconds of, V-ups, down and up, reaching for the toes. You're gonna go for 20 seconds of a hollow hold, pointing the toes, arms out in front of you, trying to keep the shoulders off the ground. And then you're gonna go for 20 seconds rest. If you're terrible at V-ups like I am, you can always go for alternating leg V-ups, makes it a little bit easier, or you can just go for some knee tucks. So you extend your legs, tuck your knees in, that'll be an option for you for today. Push-up option would be go to your knees, okay? But try and lower your chest to the ground and all the way back up. Jump squats, if you can't jump, then you're just gonna go for air squats, up and down. Cool? Awesome. So we're gonna get started on our end.
We do have one comment from Mylène Chalut. Thank you for tuning in. Everyone else who's tuned in, remember if we get to 10 participants, we have to do 10 burpees.
We always do extra burpees, so tell your friends to jump on.
We're at 6 already. Just the FSIs though, not you guys.
Well, if you guys want to do it with us, you can. All right, so here we go. Remember what I said, we're starting with the squats in 10 seconds. So jump squats, 20 seconds, hold. 20 seconds, rest 20 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and go. I don't know when that's 30 seconds. I set the wrong clock. How's it? Two, one, and hold. 20 seconds. Drive those knees out, keep the chest up, and rest. So now we're going for push-ups. As many push-ups as you can, 20 seconds. Hold the top of your plank, keep the belly tight, glutes on, 20 seconds, then rest 20 seconds. Starting in 3, 2, 1, and go.
Two, one, and hold. You can go ahead.
Check it out.
Ooh-wee.
That was the last set of squats. We're going for push-ups. High plank. Remember what I said? If you can't go with 20 seconds unbroken, take a break, small break, keep going. Here we go, 2, 1, go. All right, so this is what we got next, team. We have, like I said, the meat and potatoes of this workout. Got 3 times 5 minutes. You're gonna work at your own pace. So you might notice us, we're all gonna be not synchro for this one. We're all gonna be doing different things as well. I'm gonna give you guys some scaling options. So something to make it maybe harder. If you can't get your hand on the dumbbell, but you have a kettlebell, you can do stuff with kettlebell. If you don't have any weights at home, I'm gonna give you options as well, okay? So, number one, we're gonna go 10 single arm overhead lunges, okay? So your single arm overhead lunge, I'm gonna use a kettlebell. I'm gonna take it, get it to the shoulder, up overhead, try and keep the belly engaged, arm as straight as possible. We're gonna step forward, and you're gonna alternate sides with the legs, but you're gonna keep the same arm, okay? Keep the same arm for 10 reps. So we're going for 10 reps. In your lunge, we wanna make sure that the front knee is stacked over the ankle, okay? So you're not leaning into the toe with the heel off the ground. From there, you push from your heel to stand up. Back knee, shoulder, hip, and knee should be in one straight line here. So I don't want you overstretching the hip flexor in your lunge. Take a shorter step, keep the torso stacked upright. From there, we have swings. Well, actually, if you don't have any weight at home, pretend. Hold one arm straight, and then on your next round, you're gonna switch to the other one, okay? So from there, we have single arm swing, dumbbell swing, kettlebell swing. So Saul's gonna do this one. Really focus on using the hips to get the dumbbell or the kettlebell moving. Okay, so turn sideways for me. So you get the hip going back, a hinge, so you send your hips back. Notice that Saul only has a very slight bend in the knee as he goes back. That means that he's not using the quads to extend. He's really using the hips and the glutes to do the work here. I only want you guys to go to eye level, okay? Don't go overhead because the next movement, we're going overhead. Actually, you guys want to demo the dumbbell swing? One of you guys, maybe Matt can do it.
Dumbbell swing?
Yeah, so dumbbell's gonna be this way. So if you're using a dumbbell, so I want a little less bend in the knees and really use your hips, squeeze your butt, stand tall. Boom, just like that. Okay, so really accentuate the hip thrust. Okay, stand up rapidly, stand up with some power. You're doing it with a dumbbell like that. If you don't have any weight, all I want you to do, you're gonna reach down, touch the ground and stand. Touch the ground, stand. So I'm still working on hips going back, a little bend in the knees, back flat, almost like a deadlift here, okay? So you're gonna touch the ground with one hand. Last one's going to be a devil's press, okay? Single arm, so I want everything being done on the same arm. So if I'm starting with a kettlebell here, it's gonna be chest to the ground. So Saul's not putting his hand on the kettlebell, that's fine. He's gonna stand, grab the kettlebell, and he's going straight up overhead with it, okay? And then back down, okay? Other option, you can keep your hand on the kettlebell, push up from here, grab the kettlebell, snap through, and press up for a kettlebell snatch. With a dumbbell, it's gonna look like this. One hand on the dumbbell, going straight up, okay? So what I want you guys to think about here, it is kind of like a kettlebell swing, but I want you to try and keep it a little bit closer to your body as you go up with it, and less out and around, okay? We don't wanna go out and around, you wanna keep the kettlebell or the dumbbell close. If you don't have any weight, today it's just gonna be burpees, 10 burpees, okay? So, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, we start, we're going for 5 minutes, 10 on one arm, 10 swings on the same arm, and then 10 devil's press on the same arm, and then you switch. Okay, so we switch to opposite arm, we do our lunges, do our swings, and do our devil's press. When we finish that round, just remember where you're at, because that's where you start off on round number 2, and then round number 3. We're gonna take a 2-minute rest between each 5-minute period. Cool?
Excellent.
Yep.
Cool. Just before we get started, we just need a rating on Derek's outfit. He was a little bit self-conscious before we started the video. If you think he looks like a 10, give this handsome dude a 10, but that doesn't hold you back from being honest, okay? Do you have any suggestions?
I just didn't know if high socks would go with the classics, but you know what? I felt comfortable with it today. I did. I just rolled with it.
You look great.
Yeah. No, you look amazing.
And I feel good. Flat-soled shoe. Feel good in my squats. Feel good with the movement. So, without further ado, I'm gonna put 5 minutes on the clock here.
We can dang the cookie.
Fuck yeah, I don't know what that means, but...
You don't know what that means? You're conscious about what you look.
Well, I mean...
You look like...
I think you look great.
I mean, you know what? You look good, you feel good, right? Am I not right? So I need to look good so that I can feel good while I do this workout.
He's right.
That's right. Feel good, do good.
And then, yeah, you feel good, you do good, they pay good.
You're... Oh!
All right. Are you guys ready?
Aye, aye.
Here we go, 10 seconds. Start with the overhead lunge. 3 with music, 2, 1, and here we go. Starting with that lunge, 10 total lunges, okay? So 5 lunges per side, same arm, stays up in the air. Other arm can come out for balance here. I don't know what I'm at. I always lose count when I'm talking.
My last one, you must be done.
All right, here we go into 10 swings. So you can go right into those swings. Remember to use the hips. Again, lost track, but that's okay. More work is better. Yep. Thank you. the arm. Press towards the ceiling. Try and get a lockout.
Well done, doctor.
We're done. Dumbbell swings, or even your reach down and touch the ground, it's your hips, right? So look at my knees, barely bent here, flat back, squeeze the butt, hinge back, squeeze the butt. So I'm doing a lot of loading in my hamstrings and my glutes. I'm not doing a lot of loading in my quads, okay? So I'm trying to take the quads out of the equation. Where are we at? Okay.
I started 10 lunges ahead of him, and he caught up to me. I was at 8 devil's press. He's at 5.
It's the way he looks.
He moved. Yeah, it's the way. It's obviously the outfit. You look good. You feel good.
You look good. You feel good. You feel good. You play. It's supposed to be you play good.
Yeah.
You play good. They pay good.
Oh.
That's right.
I think it's a football player that said that once.
Probably was.
Probably Deion Sanders.
Probably was. 15 seconds, guys.
All right, guys. We're starting round number 2 out of 3.
10 seconds.
10 seconds. We got it counting down now.
All right, guys. There's a round.
Keep up your pace. I gave you some rest. That means you can move faster. Go.
We'll be right back.
my overhead lunges. I hope things are going well. Let us know how you feel with the movements.
Good push. Minute 30, flat.
We have one more set, team. One more set. Water up. Catch your breath. Don't forget to tell your friends about this class. This online class. We're moving up. Four people. Whoever's logged on right now, go tell at least one friend. If we can get 10 viewers by the end of this class, we're going to double it. We're doing 20 burpees as we can.
The stakes are higher.
Again, 20 burpees as fast as we can.
50 seconds left.
Matt is the timing.
Not a minute. Not a second.
I've got some sweat beads over here.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, good. Oh, yeah. Okay, good. Just making sure you guys are working as hard as me.
Mine are all in my t-shirt.
Yeah.
Sponsor of Swiffer.
Yeah. Let me know when it's 10, Maddie.
Yeah. 30 seconds left. I'll let you know. Last set.
Last set, guys. It's time to push. It's time to push that pace a little bit. How about we switch spots? No, we'll stay in the same spot. Just in case.
Just in case. 10 seconds.
I want you guys up front this time so that they
can. Allez, dernier tour, guys. Let's go.
They can go on your pace.
Okay, I'll move back.
I can't lunges,
place
you
can
work.
Back in your lunges.
And then can't move forward.
All good.
I got the thing I want.
Go, go!
Last one.
You
forgot to turn the music up.
DJ.
DJ.
DJ, turn that music up.
Time to push! team. What do we got for time?
We got 12
minutes. Oh yeah, we got 7 minutes to go for a stretch. Nobody better to do our stretch than Matt the Mobility Master.
Matt the Whiz, Matt the Master.
Yeah, train me.
I'm not gonna look at his Derek right now, I apologize. Great job, great push, great lead. What we're gonna get into right now is mobility. Let's get down on the ground into one knee. I'll show a front position and I'll show a lateral position. Let's start off in dynamic right now. So let's get into the stretch. Chest upright. Breathe out going forward. Breathe in coming back. Go again. I'll go from a lateral view like Cam or like Saul. Squeeze that glute that the leg's down on. That's going to lengthen the hip flexor and the quad more. Release. Go again. Release on this one, static hold. Go in, squeeze that glute, guys. Deep breath in, exhale. One more, deep breath in, exhale. Four, three, two, one. Switch legs, nothing changes. Chest upright, lateral view like Cam. Or like Saul, leaning in, squeeze that left glute now. My left leg's down, so I'm squeezing left glute. I release. Breathe out going forward. Breathe in coming back. Keep going, guys. So let's go back. Let's go forward. Hold. Deep breath. Inhale. Exhale. Squeeze that glute. Inhale. Exhale. Four, three, two, one. Slowly get out of that. Other leg now. I'm facing forward, but if you notice my leg is out to the side, the toe is pointing directly out to the side. Take that same arm that the leg's out, put it on the inside of the knee. Do not let your knee cave in when we go in that direction. So I'm staying forward, but I'm leaning laterally. Breathe in, come back. Breathe out, going forward. Do not let that knee cave in. Keep it out. It'll expose the adductor more, the inside of the leg. Get a rhythm. On this one, breathe in. Breathe out, hold. Your body's gonna wanna turn inward. Keep it out. Four, three, two, one. Everybody feel a little stretches so far?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Other side. Toes pointing out, torso forward, hand on the inside. Lean in. Like I said, the body's gonna wanna shorten. Stay exposed, open. Breathe in on the way back. Breathe out forward. At your pace, don't go at our cue, go at your pace, we're all gonna feel the stretch differently. Deep breath in, exhale, hold that. Four, three, two, one. Good there, release, good job. Let's go into a little bit of upper body now. Let's go down, sit on the back of your heels. Okay, get comfortable. I'm gonna go from a lateral view. You guys can stay from the front view there. I want the hands at 90 degrees. And if you notice, when I go back, my thumbs are pointing behind me to extend that pec more. Breathe in. Exhale. Thumb pointing behind. Try to keep them at a 90 degree angle and try not to arch your back. Okay, stay strong through the core when you go back and point those thumbs behind you. Breathe in when you close the book. Breathe out when you open the book. On this one, close, breathe in. We're going to hold on the way out. Five, four, three, two, one. Good. I'm going to go into an exercise now, a stretch now to open up the back, the scapula, and then we're going to finish off with my favorite, the Jefferson curl, as they know. Let's go now back to a front position. I'm in a front position. I see a lot of this in the bend of the elbow when people hold whichever. You want to point the whole time. Point out, reach, reach, reach. Now look where I grab. I hook my thumb, I grab at the wrist, and I open from there. No bend in my elbow. I release, and this whole time, like they're doing, we're emphasizing reaching out. You want to lengthen as much as you can, and you still want to keep pointing across. Feel that stretch, guys?
Oh, yeah.
Let's go one more. Don't let your neck come up. Try to relax the trap. This one, we're going to hold for 10 seconds when we go out. Holding. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Switch sides, nothing changes, that's your cue. Reach, 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 my thumb, and I pull, and that arm stays straight, and I'm still reaching that way, I release. Like I said, you can follow our cue, or you can hold a little bit longer, a little bit less. As long as you feel relaxed and feel this stretch, it's working for you. Last one, we'll hold on this one. When you come out, cue for 10. 10 seconds, hold. Try not to arch your back, stay upright. 4, 3, 2, 1. Good, up. Last stretch, we're gonna get into hamstrings, glutes, lower back, upper back. It's a Jefferson curl. What we're gonna do, we're gonna get into the position, turtle shell back, roundness in my back, my chin is in, and I am cradling down. If you notice, my arms are relaxed, and I am letting my back as round as much as it can to the downward part where I hold on the inside of my shins. I slowly come back up with my chin still tucked. These guys are going at their own pace just like you are. Do not come up fast because blood flow up and down with the head. So once again, chin in, round. Probably the only time I'm letting you go into kyphosis, guys. So really feel the stretch. Upper back, lower back, glutes, hamstrings. Feel the stretch, guys?
Yes, sir.
Everybody should feel it differently. If you do not feel the stretch, does not mean you're doing it wrong. We are still lengthening those muscle groups and opening up our discs, right? Last one, you guys go at your pace too. We're gonna do this last one and we're good. Hold on the way down for about 15 seconds when you get down there. Four, three, two, one. Slowly come up. I'll let Dare take the lead. Thank you for the mobility.
All right, team. Thanks for tuning in today. Remember what I said about our workout tomorrow. You don't want to miss that. Paying tribute to Nathan Cirillo. I'll just give you a quick overview. It's going to be a 24-minute AMRAP, where you guys are going to be able to push through it. You're going to need dumbbells or a barbell for one of the movements, and the other two movements are going to be body weight. That's all I'm telling you right now. That's what you're going to get out of us. Is there anything else that we need to tell them? Oh, don't forget to go onto the Facebook page. Check out our 28-day challenge. Today is balancing. It's a... today's going to be balance. Okay, you're working on balance. It's going to be 2 minutes of balance on one foot, 2 minutes of balance on the other foot. Everybody can jump into that. Let's have fun with it. See you tomorrow.
Shout out to Milan and Michelle.
Shout out to Milan, Michelle. Thanks for tuning in today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Comment on the workout. Tell us what you liked. Don't tell us what you didn't like because you liked it all. I know you guys liked it all. It was a fun workout. Tell us what you might want to see in your next one. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, see you guys.